बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, सलाम वालेकुम। ओके, फर्स्ट आई विल मेक अ रिव्यू दैट व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रीवियस लेक्चर फॉर द बेसन थ्योरम। समटाइम वी हैव सम सैंपल ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन दैट इज अवेलेबल। रिसर्चर एक्सपर्ट्स इंसिस्ट दैट दीज एडिशनल इंफॉर्मेशन और सैंपल इंफॉर्मेशन हाउ कैन बी इनकॉर्पोरेटेड विद द प्रीवियस इंफॉर्मेशन विद द प्रीवियस इंफॉर्मेशन। सो एज एन एग्जाम्पल, सपोज वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू क्राइटेरिया इन विच ईच ऑफ द स्टेट ऑफ द नेचर दे हैव द कोरोस्पॉन्डिंग प्रोबेबिलिटीज फॉर देयर। सो देन दिस एडिशनल इंफॉर्मेशन वी इनकॉर्पोरेटेड बाई द यूज ऑफ बेसन थ्योरम। सो इट विल गिव अस न्यू प्रोबेबिलिटी नोन एज द पोस्टीरियर प्रोबेबिलिटी। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दैट। वी शो यू फॉर एग्जाम्पल। स्टार्टिंग विद द सिंपल सिनेरियोस, वी वर गिवन सम स्टेट। These are the payoff. Let me change the color. These are the payoff. Okay. Then we were given the probability. We are discussing what EVP, expected value of the expected return. So obviously we will. These are the some prior probabilities were there with this payoff. Okay. Later on we discuss about the economics in which we get some additional information. This is. We get some additional form in the form of positive economic growth and the negative economic growth. Again, positive economic growth, negative economic growth. We were given also some sample information in the form of probability for each of these state of the nature: large rise, small rise, no change, small fall, large fall. What we need to do? We want to incorporate this additional information, so we will apply the Bayesian theorem. Then, for example, here previously we were only given the probability. Now, because we have the positive economic growth, negative economic growth, then with each of these state of the nature, we will compute the positive for the positive and negative each of these state of the nature with a forecast. Forecast for the negative, forecast for the positive for each of these state of the nature: large fall, rise fall, etc. The formula is as we saw that this is the formula. Previously, prior probability, then probability for the positive. It is the probability for the positive. Then we will first we'll compute the joint probability. How do we compute joint probability? First, just make a complete multiplication and solve for this one. Later on, we will compute the total probability for the positive, or refer to the same sum of probability. When you find sum of probability, all of the joint probability will be divided by the summation. Then we've computed the posterior probability for the positive. Same exercise will be performed for the posterior probability for the negative. These are the posterior probability for the negative. Posterior probability for the negative. So what we have done, let me show you. We have computed, for example, as we saw that with just use of the here you can see applying the Bayesian theorem. We have five state of the nature. This is the prior probability. Then we somehow we get this conditional probability, or in other words, we can say some additional information for the positive economic growth. Then we computed the joint probability, sum equal to 0.56. Then we computed the posterior probability for the positive. Same exercise will be performed for the posterior probability for the negative. Same step by step process will be performed for the posterior probability for the negative. Although it look like a lot of calculation will be required, but with the just use of the simple Excel sheet we can generate. So whereas the companies, financial companies, they have hundred or thousands of the software they are available. The just they feed the value automatically, it will generate the generate the positive economic growth, negative economic growth, what is the analysis, different type of analysis. Okay, come back here. What we have computed the posterior probability for the positive and posterior probability for the negative. Now come to the solution as. Now we need to compute of the expected value of the sample information. This is what we are trying to compute it. What is expected value? Expected value. It is a, let me show you the formula so that you can make your mind. Here, these are some formulas were there. This is, for example, right now we are discussing how do we compute the expected value of the sample information. It is the difference of the expected value of the expected return of the sample information minus expected return of the expected value. Noted that we have another formula which we have computed previously in the previous lecture, EVPI, expected value of the perfect information, which is the difference of an ERPI minus same EREV. As you can see, these EREV is the same. These expected return of the sample information, this will be the same. So previously we compute the ERPI, previously we have computed previously. Today what we are trying to do, we are trying to compute the EV, expected value of the sample information. So we are required to compute the ERSI. Once we computed ERSI, then we can easily compute the efficiency. What is efficiency? Efficiency equal to EVPI. EVSI divided by EPI is the efficiency. So now let's start it with the how do I compute ERSI. This is my target. Come back here. Here we have computed the posterior probability for the positive, posterior probability for the negative. Then we have discussed what we are trying to do. We have computed the EVSI, expected value of the sample information. What is this? It is the expected gain. Why? Because it is a difference of ERSI minus EREV for making a decision based on the sample information. It means this is the terminology that define what is the gain if we are using the sample or additional information. What is the criteria? What it will perform? It will revise the expected probability. Revise the expected return from each of the decisions using posterior probability. Previously we have the previous probability. Now we will not use the previous probability, but we will use the posterior probability. How? Let me see. Okay. Until now, what we discussed until now, I have already discussed in previous lecture. And today we are starting something new. So these are the conditional expected value. Conditional expected values we are. So strategy, we have the four alternatives as usual. We have the five instead of the return as usual. But here we have something new. What we know is revised posterior probability. What is revised posterior probability? That here we, instead of the previous probability, we will use the posterior probability for the positive and the posterior probability for the negative, which we have computed in the previous slide. So just replace the probability with the posterior for the positive and negative. So this is our posterior probability for the positive, and these rows shows the posterior probability for the negative. Now what we will compute? We will compute for each of the alternative what is the expected value for each of the alternative. So what we do, just multiply this probability, which is known as the posterior probability, for the corresponding payoff. So this multiply by this, plus this multiply by this, plus 0.26, 8 multiply by 200, make a summation. So what we compute? We compute the expected value for the investment in the gold, the positive forecast. For example, here, for the gold, for example, here. So as you can see, these are the calculations. So the summation is equal to 84. We will compute for all of the state of the nature. We will compute positive forecast for the company A, then company B, then company B. Same step will be performed for the negative forecast, negative growth. So as it is mentioned, expected value for the investment in the gold. Conditional part is, they have the negative forecast. Negative forecast means this will be used. The formula is the same, that 0.091 multiplied by the corresponding payoff plus 0.205 multiplied by corresponding payoff, make a summation. It is equal to 120. Okay, 120. So this is the step for the negative also we will perform for rest of the alternative. That is for the company A, company B, company C. We will compute the positive economic growth as well as for the negative economic growth for each of the alternative. So please keep this well in mind, 84 and 120. Okay. Now here for example, here for the this go for the positive 84, for the negative 120. For example, as you say, as I mentioned in the previous slide, that the for the positive economic growth, we will compute all of the expected value for the investment in company A, company B, company C. Okay, expected value we will compute it as 84, 180, 250, and 60. For the negative forecast, in the previous slide, they make a calculation for the gold. For the negative growth, it is equal to 120. Moreover, we also need to compute it for the expected value for the investment company A, B, C for the negative. That these are the corresponding values. Okay. Then what is the interpretation is, if the forecast is positive, then what is the maximum value? Maximum value is 250. Then make the investment in company B. On the other hand, if the conditional forecast is negative, what is the maximum value here? 120 value. Then if the forecast is negative, then investment make in the gold. What we identify? We identify that the for the positive forecast, this is the corresponding value. For the negative forecast, this is the corresponding value. Now let's talk about the last step. Let's talk about yes, conditional expected value. We are discussing about the various scenarios that are available in the expected value. Then moreover, as we saw that we are discussing in the expected value for the expected value of the sample information or the conditional expected value. MF now calculate the expected return from the purchasing of the forecast. From the purchasing of the forecast means he is purchasing the sample for the forecast. He has purchased some additional information. The correct is ERSI. Then ERSI, expected return of the sample information, it will be computed as, yeah, how do we compute ERSI? Positive probability, if the forecast is positive, multiply by the expected value. And what is the maximum value? The maximum value company B, the maximum value for company B and forecast is positive. Plus, first part one, second part is, if the probability is for the negative probability, positive probability for the negative, this is the positive probability for the negative. No, summation, these are the summation. Summation of all of the probability for the positive and all of the probability for the negative. Then for the forecast with the negative, multiply by the expected value. In the previous slide, we have found that the maximum value for the negative is for the gold. For the gold, then this will be our answer. Now come back so that let me show you what is the maximum value for positive is 0.56. what is the maximum value for the negative forecast? Joint probability is not the maximum value, but the joint, what is the joint probability for the positive is equal to 0.56. what is joint probability for the negative is 0.44. okay, then we found that yes, for the positive forecast, expected value for the maximum, which is equal to 250, correspond to what the investment company B. Maximum value for the negative forecast, which is 120, which is equal to investment in the gold. Then Yes, previously. Yeah, we found that this is the summation of a conditional joint probability. Summation of the joint probability for the positive forecast. Summation of the joint probability for the negative forecast. This is the maximum value for the positive forecast. Maximum expected value for the positive forecast, the maximum positive expected value for the negative forecast 120 to 250, then it is equal to 192.5. This is what is ERSI, expected return of the sample information. Now once we calculated expected return of the sample information, then we can compute EVSI, expected value of the sample information. As we saw in the previous slide, it is equal to 192.5. Whereas, as if let me show you in the previous, yes. In the previous, we have already computed ERAV, expected return of the expected value, which is equal to 130. So come back, 192.5, which is ERSI in the previous slide, and the 130, which is the expected return of the expected value, then it is equal to 62.5. Now we need to check. It means it is the ex now Ahmed need to check either if he purchased the economic growth chart or sample information by giving 50 rial. So it means now check either Ahmed getting the additional information will have the benefit or the something disadvantage. Let me, Ahmed should purchase the forecast. His expected return is greater than the forecast cost. For example, he spent 50 rial to get additional information, whereas what he got, his expected return will be 62.5, which is greater, which approximately equal to 63, is approximately 63, for example, 63. So efficiency is EVSI divided by EVPI. What is EVSI? Approximately equal to 62.5. Approximately we can say equal to 63. And EVPI we have computed with the previous 141, and it is equal to 0.45. So this is the efficiency of 45% efficient. So let's talk about what the efficiency range between 0 and 1. What interpretation? If we suppose if you have the more close value of efficiency between for the zero, suppose the value of our value is 0.1. What does it mean? And moreover, if our value for the efficiency have 0.95, what is interpretation? What is interpretation? A 0.1, which is closest to zero, it means have the low efficiency. On the other hand, low efficiency, if you have a value closest to the highest, that is close to the one. Example is 0.95. If we have the 95% efficiency, so these represent the efficiency. More efficient or less efficient? More efficiency means more value of the ERSI, more as we have more as compared to the or as compared to the EVPI. So this is the we have completed the concept for the expected value criterion. I will make a simple summarization for the expected value criteria, in which the payoff table are the same. Some, as we saw in the rest of the chapter, we have four alternative, we have five instead of the nature, payoff the table is same, but in the expected value criteria we have probabilities. Then we can compute ERAV. How? Just multiply the probability with the corresponding payoff, make a summation, and computed the expected value. The maximum of the expected value for all of the alternative is the ERAV, expected return of the expected value. Then we find the ERPI, expected return of the perfect information. फॉर ईच ऑफ द स्टेट ऑफ द नेचर द हाइएस्ट वैल्यू विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द प्रोबेबिलिटी देन मेक अ समीशन इट इज इक्वल टू ई आर पी आई एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न ऑन परफेक्ट देन इट इज देन वी कैन इजिली कंप्यूट ई वी पी आई ई वी पी आई इज द गेन इट इज द गेन फॉर द परफेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन. Later on, we discuss about the sample information. For the sample information, we got something that more information in the term of for the positive economic growth, negative economic growth. We got the information of the probability. So it means what we are trying to clear probability will need to be transformed, converted with the sample information by the use of Bayesian theorem. Then we need to compute the posterior probability. What is the first step? For each of the positive economic growth and negative economic growth, multiply with the prior probability, we compute the joint probability, make a summation, then we can compute the posterior probability for the positive, posterior probability for the negative. Then next step is we will transform, convert the prior probability with the posterior probability. Then we will find the posterior. The rest of the step they are the same. We will compute the expected value for the positive economic growth and for the negative economic growth. Then another step is we will find what is the maximum value for the positive economic growth, what is the maximum value for the negative economic growth. It will be multiplied correspondingly to the sum of the joint probability. It will compute it with the ERSI. Then obviously the rest of the step we can compute EVSI. Then we can compute the expected value of the perfect information. Now, again, make a recall. In the start of the chapter, we discuss start with the decision making with uncertainty, in which we do not have the concept for the probability, and the decision is totally depend on the lifestyle or the behavior of the decision maker. Then we talk about the expected value criteria, in which we have somehow solved the problem for the decision making under uncertainty. It means the second type, expected value criteria, in which we does not require to compute the or integrate the lifestyle of the decision maker. Some probability will be given to us. Then later on, if we find ERAV. Expected return of the expected value. Then we talk about EVPI as EVSI. Okay. Then right now we are talking about the decision making with the utility, the concept for the utility. I will make a brief overview in which we can apply where on what scenarios these concept will be applied. Okay, let's see. Started with the concept as let me please wait for a moment. Decision, it means here in this type of utility decision making with the utility concepts, it include not only for the decision making behavior and but also for the probabilities. It means what we discussed in the uncertainty, in which the important factor is the decision maker behavior. Second, then we talk about the expected value, in which we have the probability. In this category, it will use both of them, that is the behavior along with the probability. Now, where do we use this type of the scenarios? It started with the, for example, this type of scenario most likely we use in which we have the single time opportunity. For those cases, decision with the utility is the important one. Is the important one for you? Let me give the example. We make a car insurance. Why do we require the car insurance? That in the case of mishap or accident, the insurance company have to pay the money for the any individual loss. Okay, might be possible that for you make a insurance for the car and for the whole year you did not have any accident, क्लियर एंड माइट बी पॉजिटिव फॉर मेनी ईयर्स, 1 ईयर, 2 ईयर, 3 ईयर, 4 ईयर, 5 ईयर, 6 ईयर्स, और यू मे नेवर हैव एनी एक्सीडेंट एक्सीडेंट बट स्टिल यू हैव टू पे द कार इंश्योरेंस. हाउ मच अमाउंट यू नॉर्मली पे फॉर द कार इंश्योरेंस? यू मे पे फॉर एग्जाम्पल 1,000 रियाल, 2,000 रियाल, 3,000 रियाल पर ईयर पर ईयर. Obviously, for the costly car required much more. For example, I am talking about the simple one. For simple one, small car, you are required to pay, for example, 700 or 800 rial. Or if we convert it into the rupees, if we, in other words, we can say 2 rupees per day, 2 365 days, 2 rupees per day for the small car. For example, for the big car, for the 3000 rial, maybe you can say 8 rial or 9 rial per day per day. 8 year, 9 year per day. But as I just mentioned, for the whole year, or maybe 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 years, you do not have any accident. Then why do you, a person think, why do I pay the money? Why do I pay the insurance? The point is here, this is the in the category of single time opportunity. Single time opportunity means, may Allah help or protect us from any accident. In the case of accident, it is much more. For example, for the small accident, maybe we can say 5,000, 6,000, 10,000, 20,000 within the compensation for the person. Or for the big accident and in the loss of a life, the insurance company has to pay 10 million rial for the loss of a life. The insurance company they required to pay that 10 million rial. If you make the comparison, 10 million rial. And what you just pay for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 years, 10 years. 10 years. It is nothing. For example, maybe you for the whole for 5, 6, 7, 8 years, you just pay the 20,000, 30,000 or the 20,000 rial, 30,000. For the small car, for the 5 years, we can say 5,000 rial, for example. For the big car, you can say 20,000, 30,000, etc. But the insurance company had to pay this amount in the case of mishap. So what we, this will be in the category of single time opportunity. Maybe single time opportunity means for example, you just purchase the car insurance on the next day, somehow you are involved with the accident. It means accident means somehow pay the money. So you just pay. How much pay you pay? 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 rial. How much the insurance company has to be paid in the maximum for the something in the millions. So this is the category in which in the decision making utility is most helpful for all of those cases. If you try to solve the problem, a question may arise in our mind. That the, if the insurance, maybe there is a more, as for example, for the 1 year, there is a chance a person may have the accident, and if the person had the accident, then there is a chance that the insurance company had to pay money. Or for example, for the 365 days, maybe a driver, a person, he pay, for example, the 1,000 rial, and in the case of accident, he received 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. In compensation, then these insurance company will be in the loss. No, these insurance company can never be in the loss. They applied the utility theory or probability theory, and they know what is the chance for the accident. Okay, leave the chance for that. So these companies, they never have been involved in the loss. Otherwise, there's a much more difference. Something you pay in the million, and something the customer pay something in the 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, it much more difference. But these insurance companies have never been the loss. They always in the. So these are the scenarios what referred as single time opportunity. Single time opportunity. So that's why one has to, for example, in order to have the big loss, you will apply the single time opportunity. Even for example, you did not have any accident. For 10 years, you did not have any single accident. and you pay for 10 years, for example, you pay 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 real. But because of the single time opportunity, maybe after 10 years you have a single accident. Because if you then the, in the, for the compensation you have to pay something in the million. So that all of those cases. Second case is that in the casino they play the cards, they play the gamble, for example. Then also the same concept will be applies, means a person playing a card in the casino, maybe for might be possible that it is again the single time opportunity. Might, for example, he, for example, might be possible the scenario is he show his card and win the game and get all of the money. On the other hand, but for example, maybe he will make a gamble for the 100 riyal, 200 riyal, 1000 riyal, and he may receive something in the 10 times, 20 times more. On the other hand, so it's just the game for the card. Maybe game to show, maybe you have the to show the card, you will win or may you may lose. It is a single time opportunity, but the same concept we apply that the casinos, these casinos, they were never be in the loss. Never been the loss. There is something the loss. It is not the similar to the insurance company. They will shut down their companies. So what they do? Apply the decision making. Apply with the utility theory. Utility theory is involved in the single time opportunity. This is the background. This is the background for the decision making of the utility. Now come back. Decision making, we have the two alternatives were there. Buy the insurance, does not buy the insurance. Then what is the state of the nature? No accident and accident. These are the corresponding payoff were there. What is the corresponding payoff? 500 for the buy the insurance and 0 and 10,000 for the does not buy the insurance. We will know what the probability for the, these probabilities were given as 99.2% or 0.992 is they will never have an accident, whereas just the 0.8% or 0.08% they may have a chance for the accident. When we computed the expected value criteria, it is found which is the high value, it is equal to 500 probability multiplied by the corresponding payoff value, it is 580. So which one is a maximum, which one is a 500 is more than 80, it means we need to avail the buy the insurance obviously as per regulation also also be required to buy the insurance. Now for example, now decision should be not to purchase insurance, but the people almost always do purchase insurance. Means nobody willingly want to pay the insurance premium. Why do someone say, oh, I am very careful driver, and why do I pay the insurance? Nobody want to purchase it. As a normal person, we think, why should we purchase this? So, but as per regulation, we have to. So, but people, they always have to purchase the insurance. The expected value criteria may not be appropriate if the decision is the one-time opportunity, which is a substantial task. Substantial task. The point is here, previously talk about the expected value criteria. Here, these comments told that the previous expected value criteria, they may not be appropriate for the case if we have the, we want to make a decision for the single-time opportunity. For the single-time opportunity, as I give the example, what is a single-time opportunity? Then moreover, with a substantial risk, there's a much more difference between the here it is 99.2% and the other one is 0.08%, or we can say much less. There's a much more difference for the risk. Then we will not apply the expected value criteria what we have discussed in the previous. We will apply the utility criteria. Then decision maker should not, do not always choose the decision based on the expected value criteria. So the decision maker do not choose, always choose the decision based on the expected value criteria. He will not choose the criteria. Now, insurance policies cost more than the present value of the expected loss the insurance company pay to cover the incurred. Insurance company, they required to pay in the case of mishap. As I just mentioned about the 10 million rial maximum, whereas the person has to pay 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 rial. Now let's talk about the decision making and the utility. What is the basic? Although I give the background, I just show you what is the background, where do we apply the utility theory. Now let's systematically discuss the concept for the utility as. In the utility approach, it is assumed that the decision maker can rank decision in the coherent manner. Started with the utility approach, the decision maker can make the ranking of the decision. Some systematic approach, make the rank. What is the rank? I will show you what does it mean by the ranking. Utility values represented by U. Utility value represented by this symbol U in the argument V reflect that decision maker perspective and attitude. Recall that we are here the utility value, we incorporate the behavior or attitude of the decision maker along with the risk, toward the risk. Instead of maximizing expected value, the decision maker should maximize the expected utility. Now recall in the previous concept for the expected value criteria, then how they make the decision, optimal decision for the expected value criteria. In the expected value criteria, they computed the expected value for all of the alternative. The maximum value should be selected and choose as the optimal decision. Here. It is not the maximizing the here. In this case, the maximizing is instead of the expected maximizing the expected value. In this scenario, that is the utility. They will not maximizing the expected value toward the optimal decision. No, but they should maximize the expected utility. It means somehow. Let me show you. We previously were talk about the expected value. Okay. Then. We want to transform into the utility value. Utility value. In the expected value criteria, maximize this. Whereas in the utility, we will maximize the utility. Expected utility. This is expected utility. Or in other words, you can say EU. It is not the EV. In other words, you can say it is the EU. Each payoff is assigned a utility value. It means here in the previous we have a payoff table were there. So what we need to do, we want to transform the, for example, here these are the expected value. What are these? These are the payoff value. So what we will do, that we will transform, convert these payoff value into the another form, which is the utility value. This is the step what we are required to do. Utility value. Let me show you. It is the yes. In utility approach, we assume the decision maker can take the decision. Then the utility value, that the utility value. A reference maker perspective toward attitude toward risk instead of the maximizing aspect value, the decision maker that each payoff assigned the utility value. Each payoff value, as we saw, we will transform, convert into the utility value. Higher payoff, the higher utility value. Yes, if someone means the higher value for the payoff should have the higher value for the utility. If they are directly proportional, if the utility is in expected value is increasing, utility value will also be increasing. If the expected value is decreased, low value, then utility value also of the low value. The optimal decision is the one that maximizes expected utility. Then once we identify, once we make a table for the utility, then utility value, then the maximum for the utility will be the optimal decision. Now let's talk about the determining the utility value for the payoff. What is the utility value for the payoff is? List every possible payoff in the payoff table in ascending order. It means started with first we make a table in which, for example, here we will make a table here. Okay, in this we will start in the ascending order for the expect here for the payoff table in the ascending order. First in the ascending order. List every possible payoff in the payoff table in the ascending order. So this is the minimum value, then this will be the maximum value in the payoff. Recall that in the payoff table, we have the minimum value is minus 600 and the maximum value is 500. So whatever the value do we have in the payoff, we will arrange them in the ascending order. Okay, from minimum to the maximum. Then we will assign a utility of zero to the lowest value. For the lowest value, we will assign the zero value. For the maximum value, we will assign the utility value of one. Assign a utility value. This is the payoff table. Assign a utility to the lowest value, zero to the lowest value, as we saw, and a value of one to the highest value, and a value of one. What about the rest of the values for the payoff? What is the corresponding value for the utility? Okay, the corresponding, it means somehow we solve the problem for the starting and the end, the minimum and the maximum. What about the rest of the value that will cover up in the range in the between? Whatever the value we have in the we need to find the corresponding utility value. Somehow is required what we need to find out. For all other possible values, payoff, all of the possible payoff, this is all of Rij. This is all of Rij. For all other possible Rij, that is the ask the for the return value of payoff value, for ask the decision maker the following question. Suppose you are given the option to select one of the two alternatives here. How do we compute it? Suppose we were given two options. That either we can select option number one, option number two. What is option number one? What is option number two? Option number receive an Rij, one of the payoff value for sure. So we were given some, we will receive the return value, one of the payoff value for the sure. Sure means 100%. Whenever we use the word surety, it means it does not include about the probability. Means either we can have the value for the surety in which we do not have the probability, it is something very sure, then we were given the payoff value, one payoff value with the surety, Rij. Or another one is, the second option number two is, play a game of chance where you receive either. So it means we will receive the R maximum, return maximum with the P, or the lowest payoff, R minimum with the value of 1 minus P. It means what we need to find the lowest payoff. What is that lowest payoff? For the lowest payoff, okay, for the lowest payoff, which were given with the R minimum, okay. And for the either you can get this one then, because we are already familiar about the here, we just require the probability, but we know the minimum value is zero, the maximum value is one, but we don't know what is the probability, what is the minimum value, this is the maximum value, this is the maximum value, and this is the minimum value. We know whether it is utility is zero or one, but we don't know about at what probability we will got this value. We don't know what is P. So I will stop right now because this concept required the continuity. Inshallah, we'll continue the next lecture. This concept will be continued to the next lecture. So thanks of you. Thank you very much.
Isaac, sir.